Do stem cell hair loss treatments really work?
The term stem cells makes any product or treatment sound advanced, as if derived from the cutting edge of science. There are a lot of products and services using the term stem cell hair restoration, prompting many people to desperately try any treatment to help them with their hair loss. As a practicing doctor for over 25 years and the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration, where we have been helping people with male and female pattern hair loss since 2011 with a wound healing technology that recruits your adult stem cells from your own body, I feel compelled to provide some perspective and context in what appears to be a free-for-all storm of stem cell marketing. So what is a stem cell? To quote a reference from the National Institutes of Health, stem cells are a specific type of cell capable of evolving into many different types of specialized cells within the body. There are three primary types of stem cells. Embryonic stem cells are characterized as pluripotent in nature, capable of developing into the 200 or so specialized cells of the adult organism. Adult stem cells exist within certain tissues of the body, for example, blood and bone marrow, and carry out repair and regenerative functions. And induced pluripotent stem cells are adult stem cells that have been genetically reprogrammed to behave like embryonic stem cells. This definition can be confusing for anyone who doesn't have a scientific background. The FDA has made some statements about stem cell therapies in an effort to protect the public. Specifically, they made a statement titled "Consumer Alert on Regenerative Medicine Products, Including Stem Cells and Exosomes," dated July 22, 2020. In this statement, they declared the following: stem cell products are regulated by FDA, and generally all stem cell products require FDA approval. Currently, the only stem cell products that are FDA approved for use in the United States consist of blood-forming stem cells, also known as hematopoietic progenitor cells, that are derived from umbilical cord blood. These products are approved for use in patients with disorders that affect the production of blood, i.e., the hematopoietic system, but they are not approved for other uses. Exosome products are also regulated by FDA. As a general matter, exosome products intended to treat diseases or conditions in humans requires FDA approval. There are currently no FDA-approved exosome products. Exosomes and liposomes are essentially technologies which allow more direct delivery of specific drugs or other materials into cells for therapeutic purposes. In my opinion, there is a lot of potential for this technology. As far as I'm concerned, the therapeutic effects of the specific materials delivered into your cells with these technologies need to be studied for safety and efficacy as any pharmaceutical or biologic agent would be. There have been some interest in adipose or fat-derived stem cells. Procedures such as stem cell facelifts or stem cell hair loss treatments are based on a process where fat is harvested with a procedure like liposuction, and then processed for reintroductions for stem cell-induced benefits. As far as adipose-derived stem cells for hair loss is concerned, limited studies showed limited benefits, and currently this type of procedure is no longer as cutting edge as it once was promoted to be. When you have an injury, such as a cut, cells in your blood called platelets are activated to seal the injured blood vessel and recruit your body's adult stem cells for the purpose of wound healing. Since the late 1990s, dentistry, orthopedic surgery, and more recently aesthetic medicine has been using platelet-rich plasma for the purpose of directing the recruitment of adult stem cells from your own body for the benefits specific to the needs of the patient being treated. PRP alone injected into the scalp has been proven in published studies to stimulate short-term hair growth in people experiencing genetic pattern hair loss. Unfortunately, using PRP alone for hair loss is limited by the need for frequent scalp injections, typically every 1 to 3 months. We see a lot of people who get frustrated by the limited benefits and pain associated with the frequent PRP injections. I have to state that there is a lot of irony in the discovery of PRP for hair loss, as we were using PRP as part of our TrichoStem hair regeneration system many years before my colleagues decided to embrace this new technology. Many of these doctors went from being PRP detractors to PRP promoters. We have been performing TrichoStem hair regeneration treatment since 2011. Using our customized ACell and PRP protocols based on your individual hair loss profile. Acellular matrix is often referred to as ACell, which is actually the company that produces this wound healing technology derived from pig bladder. Acell's micromatrix product has been FDA cleared for wound healing applications. The wound healing benefits are essentially due to what appears to be an amplification of your body's adult stem cell response to an injury. This was the original basis for our original application of micromatrix during hair transplant surgery. A year after hair transplant surgery, it was noted that areas that were not transplanted appear to have significant regrowth and thickening of the patient's existing hair. This inspired my developing a system of customized formulations and delivery techniques of acellular matrix with PRP for the non-surgical treatment of male and female pattern hair loss, as well as for other conditions such as traction alopecia. Atypical TrichoStem hair regeneration treatment plan involves only 1 to 2 treatment sessions, with the second treatment session being done 15 to 24 months after the first. Benefits from the treatment plan typically last for 3 to 5 years or even longer, with over 99% of patients seeing an improvement in their scalp coverage. Lastly, as a note of caution, there are a lot of stem cell hair loss treatments being sold online. These products generally fail to meet any of the definitions for stem cells as previously stated by the FDA and the NIH. Much of the time, these products will be labeled with a disclaimer. This statement has not been evaluated by the FDA. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease. This disclaimer is used for legitimate products such as vitamin supplements, and it's not necessarily a red flag. However, when it comes to products claiming to have stem cells, which can be placed in a virtual shopping cart, well, caveat emptor, or buyer beware. I hope this information from my experience helped you. If you're interested in recommendations for your individual situation, you may contact us through our websites or call our offices to schedule a consultation. Thank you.